Too much clutter.
While we live, we are blessed. Hello. Take care.
There's a fine line between man and monster. Brutus, the warden of Axiom Prison, he crossed that line long ago. A big lad, and as you know from Hillock, big lads are slow. Hit and run. That's the way to cut them down to size. Unless there's thaumaturgy involved, then forget the hitting bit. Just... that medicine chest you found, it'll do more than you might think. The medicine will run out, it always does, but Nessa won't. Give that girl a sliver of hope and she'll carry it to the end of the world. Farewell.
That would just make life complicated.
Hello.
A pained spirit hijacks a body, and will not be stopped by their body's demise.
Ignorance brought you here, sister. To the one place where your talents are free to grow and be truly feared.
Still, the Karui barbarians advance upon us. Linai is dead, his legion slaughtered along with every eternal man, woman, and child from Linai's watch to the foot of our axiom. Should the need arise, we shall retreat through Prisoner's Gate, raising my barricade behind us. Yet our salvation is at hand. Foul times demand heroic deeds, and through my arts, our Lord Brutus will arise anew to defend us. May the dry sands quench their thirst with Karui blood when our mighty warden delivers his judgment upon them.
My loyal Declan, give our Lady Piety your absolute support and watch her with absolute scrutiny. There is much to learn from the likes of the Inquisitor, the Umbra, and the Soulless One. I would hate for Piety to feel that she needs shoulder such perilous wisdom alone. Dominus.
You know Tonsery. Come and share it with me.
Been my creation, brute. You'd not have fallen so easily. Too much clatter.
Chevron, you have certainly had your work cut out for you with Lion Eyes Legion. Do not concern yourself with Marseilles' complaints. Our Emperor is fully aware of the General's fickle nature. As to your need to accelerate the implantation process, I can recommend a quite simple alteration. Dip the gem in a boiling solution of 6 parts blood and 1 part thormetic sulfite for no more than 13 seconds. Any longer, and you invite the crystal's wrath. Once the gem is withdrawn from the solution, you have but a few seconds to install the gem in the prepared flesh and close the wound. Should the gem cool too much prior to implantation, it will become inert, and your patient with it. Trust in that bountiful talent of yours, Shivan. My thoughts are with you, Malachi.
The Warden's free of his own prison. Well, since you're so bloody determined to cheat the britches off death, you'd better have one of these, for luck. And when they write the song about you, just be sure to mention that it was Tarkley who taught you everything you know.
Farewell.
For some, death is welcomed with open arms. Did you end Brutus's suffering out of avarice or mercy? Only you know the answer to that one. Yes? Farewell. Hello. Farewell. What little help I can offer is yours. Goodbye.
Thank you.
is too precious to waste on you.
This is for your own good, sister.
Thank you.
Too much clutter.
Still alive, are we? Why would Piety go and cut us off from the interior? Well, thankfully, I don't have it in me to know what that witch thinks. But I reckon you'll work it out, once you've lowered Chevron's barricade for us, of course. Farewell.
Be well. Yes? While we live, we are blessed.
Thank you.
The sirens appear to be dining well.
Frankly, I would have been surprised if you hadn't recognized me. Yes, 'tis I, Captain Sigmund Fairgraves, wave tamer, pirate bane, and conveyor of civilization to barbaric lands. So, what am I doing here? Apart from blowing my own beauty, stuck fast in the filthy mud of Rayclast, thanks to one sultry little slave girl. I liberated her from the flesh pits of Trathus, and she repaid me in full with sleight of hand and swift feet. Turned the coat of my first mate, took my hard-earned all-flame, and with it, the wind out of my sails. Find my all-flame, I beg of you. Until I feel its warmth again, I hunted the vagaries of a near-forgotten myth to a shattered cathedral in the Inner Empire. I took the All-Flame and encased it within a lantern of pure silver, the only element it seemed incapable of consuming. Oh, the All-Flame does many a marvelous thing in the hands of one who knows how to harness it. My loveliest neighbor in this most salubrious of neighborhoods. Facing Mervale and finding my all-flame are two mutually exclusive endeavors. I'd much prefer you to live to see your errand fulfilled. Although it is possible that my wayward slave girl fell prey to one of Mervale's slithering progeny. If that be the case, you look resourceful enough to handle a tentacled wench or two. But if the history books are to be believed, Doreso the Daring presented the necklace to Mervale on bended knee. And from the moment he placed that little chunk of Rayclast at her throat, Mervale began to sing. It's told her sweet voice grew to fill even the largest concert halls of Oriath and brought warmth to even the coldest of hearts. But then she began to change. Her mind and body twisted, as did her songs. All the sweetness remained. Till we meet again, perhaps.
Calm stands before us and looks out to the raging sea. He sings, calls, screams to our ancestors to come to our aid. He offers them gifts of old, a feast of heart and mind, muscle and marrow, cooked in the fire and rock of this angry land. We have not practiced these ways in so many years. Only in the darkest of times, most desperate of times, do we perform these oldest of rituals. Only here and now may we sacrifice and consume our own. Only in our king can we trust this return to our ancient selves.
Thank you.
Recognize myself.
Calm is gone. Our king has taken our finest 500 warriors and descended into the depths of Rayclast. He spoke to us of a vision, a gift from the ancestors. Calm has been deceived. The vision was a gift from the Black Spirit. It has conquered Calm. The Black Spirit has conquered the Karui way. Hyrie has made ready her canoes. We will take those that are left, 500 forgotten families, and carry them back to their true homes.
Too back much clutter.
To Nga Maka Nui. Calm's promises have led us into nightmare. Hyrie will lead us back to the dawn.
Mmm.
Welcome. Fate awaits you.
Stay sharp out there.
Mervale dwells in the caves beyond the wrecks, at the head of Siren's Cove. Leave her be, and we can only hope that she continues to return the favor.